Hey guys, it's Dr. Greer. Today I'm talking about age spots, and this is a hot topic because they're one of the two main things that make our skin look older. Age spots and wrinkles, that's it. You may notice brown spots popping up in your hands, your chest, your face. So first off, let's differentiate age spots from other things that cause brown spots. Unlike freckles, age spots will get darker in the sun, and then they don't lighten up during the winter when you're not out in the sun. Freckles do lighten up during the winter. Age spots will get darker and then they kind of stick around, which is very frustrating. They're also different from melasma. Melasma is very patchy. You may see it on the cheeks or the forehead, especially during the time of pregnancy, which is why it's called the mask of pregnancy. And melasma is different in that it's hormonally driven and it's very, very sensitive to sun exposure. So sun exposure will drive all of the forms of hyperpigmentation we're talking about today because it increases pigment production. But with melasma, even if you have skin exposed to sun that doesn't have melasma, like if my forearms are out in the sun, it can make melasma on my face worse. Same thing with light exposure of your retinas. So you need to wear sunscreen and sunglasses if you have melasma, because even just the light hitting your eyes can cause that melasma to get darker. So that's melasma versus age spots. And then there's another type of brown spot that you should know about called a seborrheic keratosis. And those are the ones, like I have patients who call them barnacles, and they'll come every year or so to get the barnacles removed. Seborrheic keratoses look really waxy and they sit on the surface of the skin rather than being inside the skin layers. And you can like actually pick them off. Those do not respond to laser treatments or skincare. Those have to be physically removed either by cautery, like where I burn them off, I can cauterize them off with the laser, or you can freeze them off. So those are a whole separate thing. But melasma and then your regular age spots, also known as solar lentigines, are what we're going to talk about today. So my first go-to approach for brown spots is always skincare, because if you don't have the basics in order, the other stuff isn't going to last. You can get laser treatments to remove the brown spots, but if you're not maintaining with skincare, they're going to come back more quickly. And you can get some really dramatic improvements just with skincare, no laser treatments at all. So let's talk about the four products that you need to have in your skincare routine if you have age spots or melasma. Number one, sunscreen. Okay, this is important because UV exposure increases pigment production. If you're not stopping the UV exposure, then all that pigment is just going to keep forming and you can't get rid of it. It's kind of like trying to clean the house when your kids are coming behind you, pulling all their toys out. It doesn't work. I like a mineral-based sunscreen rather than the chemical sunscreens. And the reasoning is that chemical sunscreens break down throughout the day. So not only are you absorbing weird chemicals, but they're not as effective. And you're going to look for a sunscreen with the ingredients zinc oxide or titanium dioxide. Yes, it is the white pasty stuff lifeguards used to put on their noses, but the new formulations are really sheer and absorb nicely. And there are even some tinted formulations. Like right now, I have on the Illumier Moisture Matte Tinted Sunscreen in Ivory. So I actually use this instead of foundation, which is really convenient. So number one, sunscreen every day. It should not just be the sunscreen in your makeup. You're not putting on enough. And every morning, put it on. Okay. Second product that you'll want to use is a hydroquinone. Hydroquinones work by blocking tyrosinase, which is an enzyme in the pathway to make pigment. So basically it stops more pigment from forming. And hydroquinone is the go-to product for that. You can get it over the counter in a 2% formulation. Prescription strength is 4%. There are even higher formulations, but there's no data to suggest that more is better after 4%. And in my office, we carry the Obagi Clear. That's a 4% hydroquinone. Hydroquinone is a little unusual though, because after 3 to 5 months, the melanocytes, the cells that make pigment, can stop responding to it. And you can actually get this rebound hyperpigmentation. So I recommend not using hydroquinone for more than about 3 to 4 months. Conveniently, that's about using one bottle of the Obagi Clear. And after that, you'll need to change to a non-hydroquinone skin lightener. And those have different botanical compounds like licorice root, gojic acid, that also block melanin production. They're not quite as strong and they do it in slightly different ways. The one that we offer is Illumier Intellibrite. So you'll kind of alternate between a hydroquinone product and a non-hydroquinone, like every 3 months switch off. And that way you're going to get the most effective lightening and pigmentation. And that's important for maintenance as well, the sunscreen, the hydroquinone. third line of attack is a retinol or a retinoid. I know I've talked about these before. Retin A or tretinoin is the active vitamin A derivative that increases cell turnover, so it makes your cells actually form new skin cells sooner. It also does block melanin production a little bit. Now, those can be really irritating, like if you use Retin A, and they can cause a lot of redness and flaking. So I like to start off with a retinol, which has to be metabolized by your skin to the active ingredient. So it's a little bit more gentle. And those you use at night, let them absorb into the skin, and then you can put moisturizer on over it. That's a great anti-aging product that I recommend across the board for everyone. And then the last component of your skincare routine to lighten up brown spots is going to be exfoliation. And here we're talking chemical exfoliation. Please don't get the St. Ives apricot scrub. Too rough. I like using either a real mild lactic acid or an alpha hydroxy acid product, and putting that on in the morning is going to help exfoliate the cells on your skin that already have the pigment. So not only are you stopping new pigment from forming, you're getting rid of what's already there. Now, a full cycle of skin cell turnover is about 6 weeks, so you should start to see an improvement in 4 to 6 weeks using this skincare regimen. And I've seen some really dramatic improvements in patients with pretty noticeable melasma just using these four products. If you don't see a huge improvement, then we may want to speed things up a little bit with some chemical peels, and that will just kind of help remove those outer layers of dead skin, which A, have pigment in them, and B, then your skincare products can penetrate a little bit more effectively. You may get just enough improvement with just doing that. And if not, or you want to speed things up a little bit more, that's where we bring in the laser. My go-to laser treatment for everybody, again, one of the like big anti-aging things that I recommend for all people, is a Forever Young BBL. BBL is broadband light, also called IPL, which is intense pulse light. They're the same thing. It's basically a very bright light, and then we apply filters. So it's not a true laser, but it allows us to filter out the wavelength of light, 515 nanometers, that attacks pigment. And what it does is it actually like vaporizes the pigment, which is then pushed to the skin surface and flakes off. So if you have a lot of sun damage and you have a BBL treatment, it'll almost look like coffee grounds on your skin, and then they flake off. It's awesome. The first treatment's always the most dramatic. And then after that, because we've pulled out so much pigment, it's not as cool. But I love that treatment. Most people will need a couple of treatments to get a good improvement. Again, it depends on what kind of skincare regimen you're using. But then doing that twice a year, fall and spring, is not only going to help remove sun damage as it pops up, prevent those dark spots from getting darker, it's also going to build collagen, which will keep you from getting wrinkles. And then the other option we have is an ablative laser treatment. So the BBL only attacks the pigment. The skin is unharmed, which means it's non-ablative. There's really minimal downtime, like you're a little red for a couple hours, and you can wear makeup right away. With ablative laser treatments, we're actually vaporizing the skin itself. And there's the traditional laser peel where you do the whole skin surface. Not going to work great for pigment, because if you get deep enough to get to the layers with pigment, it's going to take like weeks to heal. So we do pixelated laser treatments, and you may have heard them called Fraxel, Pixel. We have the Halo, which is fractionated and actually is two wavelengths, so one goes down deeper. And those will break up the pigment. And because they're in a pixelated pattern, there's healthy skin cells that will heal the tiny little microscopic wounds in between. So healing time is much shorter. You know, we're talking like 4 or 5 days instead of 2 weeks. But there is some downtime where you're going to have to use some Aquaphor, Vaseline, heavy moisturizer, and sun protection. Those will also help with fine lines and wrinkles too. So they're really nice for pigment and sun damage. And I especially like the Halo if you have poikiloderma, which is like the patchy red pigmentation that is from chronic sun damage. So those are my go-to treatments for age spots. Always start with a skincare program and then laser as needed, which will also help with other things like fine lines. And if you feel overwhelmed, it's okay. You can always come see us in Cleveland, or you can even just get a customized skincare plan made specifically tailored for you if you go to greerplastics.org/skincare-routine. And I'll put the link in the video description. All you do is submit some photos and tell me, you know, what you're having issues with. And then I can recommend products that you can buy online so that you can get some improvement in that pigmentation without even having to leave the house. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you have any questions about age spots, leave them in the comments and I will get to them as soon as I can. And if you have ideas for other videos too, I would love to hear those. Be sure to subscribe to us so that you don't miss any answers or future videos I do that you might be interested in.